I would now like to invite Mr. Alok Verma, Policy and Regulatory Affairs at Amplus Solar, to address the audience.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. Before we go in, I'll start my presentation. Let me again just quickly walk you through about Amplus. So Amplus is a I-squared-backed solar power, distributed solar power developer. We are backed by a PV private equity firm known as I-Square Capital. It's a US-based and an $8 billion PE group, and they have we have around $150 million commitment from them their side. So financially, we are a very stable company, and in terms of projects, we have already executed around 68 megawatt of our rooftop projects and 34 megawatt of a solar park in Karnataka. In parallel, and at the same time, we are also executing 130 megawatt of a solar park, another solar park in Karnataka, and created a pipeline of 150 megawatt of a solar, different type of a solar projects in India. Other than India, we are also focusing on Southeast Asia and Dubai. We are just about to start our first project in Dubai very soon. And we are a Gurgaon-based company. It's almost 200 plus professionals working in the company. I look after policy and regulatory affairs. So I'll just start with directly want to hit on the issues and challenges. We have been hearing this, that the potential is enormous, and Government of India, state government has been putting a lot of thrust on the development of the solar projects, especially the rooftop. We have set a target of 40 gigawatt by 2022. So there are already drivers for the growth. We have seen there is no brainer for the commercial and industrial consumer about solar rooftop. They are driven by their high electricity tariff rates and the empty rooftop available with them, and they really want to reduce the cost of their end product. And for all these industries, electricity is a raw material, so they are always focusing on energy efficiency and bringing down their end product cost. So as of now, we see there's though there is a lot of push from the government side, but so far we have achieved almost a gigawatt of installation, which is dominated by industrial, commercial consumer. And if you look at the proposed target, which is 40 gigawatt, so in next 5 years, then we need to do almost 8 gigawatt every year, which itself seems to be a very, very uphill task. But our country is very, very equipped with all the drivers. So like I said in this our slide, that there is no brainer for C&I consumer. At the same time, all sort of a renewable energy, including solar and wind, they have already reached to the grid parity long time. And if we see the tariff trend across India, North India, West, Southern, and Eastern India, so we can see an upward trend in the retail electricity prices, be it agriculture, be it commercial, industrial, or the residential. So there is already a case for rooftop across the segment. But why we are not moving as quickly as we have envisaged, and what are the barriers for it? So there are some barriers which are hindering the growth. So just we'll talk about those barriers in the upcoming slides. At the same time, what we see, there are business models available for all sort of an investor and the consumers. There are cell phones, people like Amplus, Cleanmax, which are working on the developer model. There are companies like Harsha Abacus. They are also working on the CapEx mode, providing installation to the consumer rooftop. Every model have their merits and demerits. But what we see, in spite of all the factors, all the drivers, there is some hindrance in the growth. So what we see, we can bucket in the challenges into four categories. One is the policy and regulatory challenges. Second is the credit risk, procedural delay, and there is absence of incentives from the distribution company. So in terms of policy and regulatory challenges, what we see, there is a huge inconsistency across the India, once from state to state. Like for an instance, if we go to the North India, be it Delhi or Uttar Pradesh, there is a provision for third-party sale, which is like a developer model that has been allowed for all the consumers. But when we come to the Gujarat, so there is a restriction on this particular model. So because of the restriction, consumer himself has to invest on the solar power project and cuff out a huge sum of money for the amount of kilowatt or megawatt he intends to install on his project. Then there is a capacity cap on the solar projects. Even though there are rooftops available with the consumer, but they can't go above 1 megawatt. Then there is a asymmetry in the government policies and the regulations. So at some places, what we have seen, government is focusing a large scale deployment on the rooftop projects like Punjab. So the government has already allowed 10 megawatt of solar projects to participate in the net metering project, but there are no regulations for it. Similarly, in Haryana, there are certain incentives made available under the state solar policy, but same has not been implemented by the regulator. So there has been an asymmetry between the policy and the regulation. So that is one part of the the barriers. Second is the credit risk. So like I said earlier, the market, the rooftop market, is primarily being driven by the CNI consumer, but there is a huge scope available and CNI consumer, which are highly rated consumer, but there is a huge scope, the huge potential available with the consumer which are not highly rated, which are a low rated consumer, but they can still contribute in the development of the sector. So there are certain solutions to come out of these risks and challenges, the drivers. So I'll be very quick in just giving a brief of the drivers because of the time constraint. I already got a 1 minute left notice. So, but if the audience allows, I would like to continue with my bit more of a present the issues. So anyway, any questions if you have, you can ask in the panel discussion. But let me just brief, very very brief, about the other challenges and the issues. So there are procedural delays, there are absence of incentive to the DISCOMs, and similarly we have identified the barriers, at the same time we have also identified the solutions to it. So solutions can be there, the policy and procedural delay has to be removed, there has to be standardization of the process regulation, there has to be incentive made available to the distribution company so that they don't feel that we are taking away their consumers and we are taking away for their revenues. And there has to be adoption of new business models. So a couple of business model could be the developer model can be coupled with the distribution licensee. This will also minimize the payment risk. Second could be the bank, the international, the lenders can also play a very vital role in enhancing the credit credibility of the consumer and allowing them to participate in the RESCO model. So there will be a challenges, but there will always be a solution. So what we look at one of the major industry stakeholder, that we need to work together and we need to make certain changes in all sort of verticals of our industry. So with this, I would like to give a pause to my presentation. Thank you very much. Thank you so much for listening and your patience.
Thank you very much, Alok. That was a very interesting session. And sorry to have rushed you. What we have now is we have one more session. And if we have time, I'll try and squeeze in one more round of session. And then we will open the panel for questions. And after that, I think we'll break for lunch. Okay. I would now like to invite Mr. Gambhir Balyan of Everest Solar to address the audience.
Yeah, good afternoon. I am Gambhir Balyan from Everest Industries Limited, which is a roofing solution provider company. As I have mentioned in my earlier introduction, that we are the new entity, a new startup into the solar business. And I was looking after the one of the presentation of the earlier session, that there was one of the challenges we are facing. We are not a suitable roof for rooftop solars. We have taken venture has started based on this to solving the problem of the rooftop. As we have a target of 40 gigawatt for 2022, it's our estimate that it will require 4.5 billion square feet of the roofs, out of which approximate 70% roof will be coming from the new construction like our company is doing. And therefore, the requirement of the optimized roof solar is very vital. Why the roofs, solar roofs are vital? Because of its slopes, favorable generation, for favorable generation, angles, design of roof, type of the roof, which type of it is a, whether it is a trapezoidal or it is a other type of, layout of the plan, shadow during the planned planning, walkways, roof accesses, safety. This helps us in safety during installation and reduce the installation time. We have done one of the case studies with our buildings. See, Everest is a company which is doing a roofing solution more than 8 to 10 lakh square meter every year, including the pre-engineered steel building as well as other metal roofing and asbestos roofs and other types of roofs. We have done one of the case studies with the industry that the building is layout north-south facing, which is having a 1,20,000 square feet of area, but usable area is only because 37,800 square feet because of the various obstructions coming over the roof, like turbo vent, ridge vents, all these obstructions. Therefore, reducing the capacity of the roof by 70% and loss of 23 crore of potential savings. Another case study we have done for the another MNC companies, where the roof is available for 2 megawatt capacity of solar plant, but we can't use because they have not taken the load while designing the buildings. We as an Everest company is designing the building also. So we are advising our consultant customers to take the load, proper load for the solar rooftop plant. Therefore, the loading to be taken more than 150 kg per square meter or 15 kg per square feet. Other case study we have done, as we are the structural company, we are finding a lot of problem with the roofs, where a lot of utilities are coming over the roof. We can't construct the building. We can't construct the RTS. So we are designing our structure in such a way so that we can provide the panel over that. So the new roofs with optimized solars have durability, safety during the operation and maintenance, ease of installation, leakage proof, optimum angle, exhaust provisions. All these we can do during our planning stage and during the construction stage. So industry wins with the Everest solar friendly buildings, have low installation cost, leakage prevention, save during the durable and reduced gestation period. Thank you. This is the smallest presentation. It will save your time. Thank you. Anybody ask the question, I can reply during the question answer session. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kambir. That was indeed short and sweet. We are already at 1, and I know that lunch is some time away. I will just try and squeeze in one more session. Mr. Piyush Bhatheja from Statkraft PLP. I'm afraid you only have 5 minutes. So.
Madam Moderator, my fellow panelists and audience, first of all, I'm thankful to you and, of course, the organizers for giving me this opportunity to speak at this forum. I would say that most of the points have already been covered in the last and this session, but I'd just make an attempt to add to whatever has been said. So one of the speakers before me, Mr. Alok Verma, very nicely captured most of the points pertaining to the industry where developers and financiers are actively engaging. Of course, as outlined by the chief guest for the event himself. Solar, and especially rooftop solar, has started making complete commercial sense in isolation. Now we don't need any other incentive to go solar rather than just the economic sense that it makes for any commercial or industrial segment consumer. Having said that, the scenario is not completely rosy, and there are still a few hindrances which are there in the industry. So a few of them have already been spoken about. The biggest one being the inconsistency in different state policies, and the various state DISCOMs are also making stealthy attempts to make it more difficult for consumers to adopt rooftop as well as off-site solar. So whether we talk about OPEX rooftop solutions or the off-site open access solutions, the DISCOMs are trying to do whatever they can to make it difficult for the consumers to adopt it. And of course, there is this sort of renegotiation in the tariffs that is also looming large over already executed projects. Another issue is that the solar by itself, by its very nature, is not uniformly or evenly spread out all across the country. So there are certain states which are blessed with more solar generation, solar radiation, as compared to some of the other states. And that is why the government came out with a scheme like RPO or REC mechanism, by which the fruits of solar could be utilized by any consumer or any off-taker being present anywhere across the country. But unfortunately, even that has not been very uniformly enforced in the country. So one of the solutions to all these problems can be to enforce the much talked about green corridor and make it more convenient for a generator sitting in one particular state, for example, for a generator in Maharashtra to supply to a consumer in, let's say, Karnataka or Andhra Pradesh. So we need to have the enabling provisions and regulatory clarity for these aspects. And of course, one of the major talked about topics is storage. So it'll be really helpful if the government can come out with more clearer policies for dealing with storage in the coming years. That'll be all from my side. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Piyush. What we will do now is, we will open the floor for question and answers. I will take the lead, and I'll ask thoughts that I'm sure will also reflect you may want to be to ask. And after that, happy to take questions from you. My first question goes to Sirsanath Banerjee from Tata Cleantech Capital. Sirsanath, being a lender, obviously in utility scale, there are enough. It's a proven space, so to say, and there are lots of examples of even innovative funding from the lender side being received by that sector. But for rooftop solar, what are you observing as being part of that group of set of investors, in terms of how open are lenders to lend to that sector? What are the challenges? What would they like to see happening more to give them more comfort?
Thanks, Sweta. So on rooftop specifically, my belief is that this is a segment that is hard to ignore at this point of time, because utility scale has its own challenges. We all spoke about what the state DISCOMs have been up to. Rooftop in Gujarat, for instance, Patilji mentioned that the target is close to 8,000 megawatts of rooftop solar by 2022. Now, Gujarat seems to have about 12 million households, of which 40-45% is urban households, which translates to about 5 million. Even if half of those install at least 1 or 2 kilowatt capacities, we should be able to achieve close to 70-80% of the target of Gujarat alone. So this segment is hard to ignore. hard to avoid. And as lenders, we are looking at it proactively. And I think this is going to be the next wave of reform in the power sector per se. And we as lenders are gearing up for it as much as developers are.
Sure. I have a follow-up question to that. Specifically, are you seeing, you know, maybe not just banks, but even NBFCs, you know, getting comfortable to lend to an open access consumer, for example, whose consumption, you know, may not be, you know, sub one megawatt, but maybe a substantial 20, 25 megawatts, you know, who are actually giving out, you know, boot of 15, 20, 25 years also. Are you seeing lenders now, you know, coming up the curve and getting comfortable to lend to such projects?
Right. So lending traditionally has been of two natures, with recourse, without recourse. We are now seeing a lot of pure non-recourse loans being sanctioned to rooftop projects and companies, CapEx and RESCO model both alike. Of course, there are challenges. There are challenges around the sanctity of the PPA. You mentioned 25 years. Now, coming to the salvage value of the asset for 25 years is a task in itself, and we are yet to probably test the time period to say conclusively whether this is a good model or not. But having said that, yes, we are open to distributed generation. We are working with likes of Cleanmax, Amplus. We have them on the panel here. And I think there's a paradigm shift, not just in banks. You mentioned NBFCs. We are an NBFC. So we are an intra-finance company, IFC NBFC. And I see that shift very clearly across the industry.
Sure. Any of the other panelists, if they would like to add, please feel free.
I just like to add one thing here. I just want to ask one thing here. Whenever I sit and discuss for rooftops, let's talk in the length of like 500 kilowatt to 1 megawatt range. And when it comes to funding, so what kind of thoughts you are having when in the terms of standardizing of the BOM or the kind of product which is coming in when you're lending money? So that is one of the major questions which is coming in. And in a few of the financial forums, even I have seen a debate going on the standardization of BOM, what kind of products coming in, bankability of the system and the product. So how do you look at it? No, I'm talking about the system. Yeah, balance of the system, yeah.
See, I would not have any comments per se on the balance of system specifically, because as financiers, we are financing the project. We are taking a call on the PPA that you're signing with the off-taker. I would also want to, you know, put in a word of caution. We are all chasing IRRs, right? And in this, there's a lot of exuberance in the market. There is a lot of talk about flipping operating assets into InvITs and getting a premium out of it. I would want to, you know, really give a shout out to all the developers here that please be cautious, because even the InvITs which are trading currently are trading at a discount of about 5%. So we are not here to operationalize the assets and sell them off, but to be with the assets in the long run. And I'm not sure about the developers, but at least the lenders will have to stay. So that's a risk to us.
I'm sure the invite of open access and rooftop solar assets is a long time away.